has no place in a science class. And this threat is very, very real. And it's a battle that's been going on for a lot of years, really ever since Darwin came. There have been people who have said, okay, we don't want to confuse our kids by teaching about evolution. They just need to learn a religious viewpoint on how life arose, and that's all they need. And there are a lot of people who think that way. And at some point, you will come across that kind of attitude. And if you happen to live in Kansas or Pennsylvania...
I'm from Kansas.
All right. So, have you been following what's been happening there with school, local school boards?
I haven't, no. I went to public school there, but it was an elementary school, so we didn't really get into all that.
Didn't get into the evolution part. I mean, I think still they're holding on, but every session of the legislature, bills are being introduced that say you have to teach both sides. That's the mantra we keep hearing. Teach both sides. Now, if ever any of you plan on having children or have children already, this is important to you because the education of your children's children, depends on this. So this lecture is just a review of some of the threats that are facing science education in general, and I use evolution as an example because you see the same thing. In North Carolina, they actually managed to pass a bill in the state legislature that it is illegal to report that climate change is happening. They're saying that any state funds cannot be used to lead to a finding of climate change happening. And it would be wonderful if politicians could say, oh, there's no climate change, and it stopped happening. That'd be great if someone could do that, but because we can't. But politics is getting into science more and more and more. And science always will lose that battle because politics is not better informed than science, even though politicians would have you believe it is. So this is just a way of making you aware of some of the threats against science, particularly science education, using evolution as an example, because as we go through this, we see ways to address the threat. And it's kind of a good refresher on everything we know about evolution. So that when you find yourself up against somebody who says, oh, I don't believe in evolution, you have some ammunition that if you wish to get into that discussion, you can. If it's a family discussion, probably not recommended. If it's against somebody who is asking for your vote, highly recommended. And by the way, I don't believe in evolution either. Evolution is not a belief system. Evolution is evidence-based, and that is not a belief system. I don't believe things evolve. I know things evolve. And that's the big difference. You've got belief systems, and you've got evidence-based systems. And those two things are different. And there is no place for belief systems in a science class. That's the big issue. So we're going to start off, what is creationism? What is intelligent design? And what is the best approach to take a stand against what essentially is the dumbing down of science classrooms. Because politicians have a vested interest in having a dumb electorate. Because what is the best way to get elected? Come up with a catchy bumper sticker. Have a 15-second television ad. You know, my opponent bites the heads off live chickens. That's all you need to do. That opponent will never get elected. Because they rely on the majority of the electorate not being able to analyze issues, not being able to see what is the truth behind all this. And this has even been taken to extreme, and I will not say which party it was that was doing this, but on one of the party platforms of one of the two major political parties in this country, in Texas, their party platform had, as one plank of that platform, to stop the teaching of critical thinking in schools. If you want the web address, I'll give it to you. It's in there. I think in the end they took it out. But they were campaigning in the last presidential election, the last general election. That was in there. Because too much time was spent teaching students to think. And we don't want students to think. We want them to memorize facts. Because if they can think, they can see through the arguments that they make. That's why as university students, as educated people, I mean, you are the elite. You are the intellectual elite. And you know that, right? Because you have got this far. You now are better equipped than the majority of people in this country to make rational decisions. And that's a heavy responsibility. It's one you need to take very seriously. So that's where we go with this. And it really is one big quick thing. And I'm going to start off, let's give it a couple of minutes, just to get us into the mode, get us all riled up, and we can finish it on Thursday. So creationism, and I picked on one religion and one holy text, simply because this is the religion that is really pushing the creationist agenda, the anti-science agenda in this country. There are other countries with other major religions that also are trying to do away with the teaching of evolution. But since in this country it's primarily coming from biblical creationism, that's what I'm going to pick on. So creationism is this, that in the first verse of the first chapter of Genesis, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. That was how everything got started. And creationism, and this is taken from a website called creationism.org, which is one of the more mainstream creationist organizations. Creationism is the theory that man, the earth, and the rest of the universe were originally created rather than randomly exploding from nothingness into chance existence. That's the statement, the mission statement. So does the theory of evolution, as you understand it, hold that man randomly exploded from nothingness? Is that a fair read of the theory of evolution?
I'm just thinking about something that I learned in Bio 122. About the experiment with the organic material and the inorganic and the organic. I forgot what it was called, but I remember it.
Good, you all pass, you can leave. Good, thank goodness. No, of course, it doesn't hold that man randomly exploded from nothingness. Randomness in mutation, sure. Is natural selection random? It's the very opposite of random. So, good. I mean, what we're seeing now is that you can say a lot of things, and you can say, my opponent fights the heads off like chickens. Or you can say, the theory of evolution says that man randomly exploded from nothingness. You can say anything you want. What you need to say is, wait a minute, no it doesn't. No it doesn't. You have the understanding to be able to do that, to take that standing. So we'll continue this theme on Thursday. Do me